חג שמח.
חג שמח.
לחיים. So, we're celebrating now a very special holiday, Tu Bishvat. So I'm just going to say a few words about the holiday, because it's not such a popular holiday. Many people don't even know what it is, why we celebrate it, where it came from. We know the, you know, the regular holidays. We know Pesach, we know Sukkot, Rosh Hashanah, Purim. But it says that there are four times in the year that is called the Rosh Hashanah, ahead of the year. So we just know the one on Tishrei, the first day of Tishrei, that it's the Rosh Hashanah, for the head of the year. But our sages teach us that there are four Rosh Hashanah. The first one is on the first day of the month of Nisan. The second one is on the first day of the month of Elul. And the third one is the first day of the month of Tishrei, the one we're more familiar with. And the last one, the fourth one, is on the first day of Shvat. Now there's a contradiction between Beit Shammai and Beit Hillel, if it's the first day of Shvat or the 15th day of Shvat. So Beit Shammai, they say the first day of Shvat. Beit Hillel say, no, it's the 15th day of Shvat. And we go by Beit Hillel, and we celebrate Tu Bishvat on the 15th day of Shvat. We know from the Mishnah that there are 4 days in the year that the world gets judged. So we all know Rosh Hashanah, that the world gets judged, but in each one of these Rosh Hashanah, the world gets judged. The Rosh Hashanah that is on Pesach is the Rosh Hashanah for the kings, for Melachim. The Rosh Hashanah for Elul is the Rosh Hashanah for Maaser. The Rosh Hashanah in Tishrei is for the years and the periods, the time, the Moadim. And the Rosh Hashanah that we're celebrating now is the Rosh Hashanah Leilanot, for the trees, for the vegetation. Now, every one of these Rosh Hashanah, the world gets judged. So we know on Rosh Hashanah, the one in Tishrei, the whole world gets judged. Everybody is passing in front of God, and there's judgment on each one, and each thing, even animals, everything, not only human beings. All the nations of the world, everybody gets judged on that day. But on this day, on Rosh Hashanah, Leilanot, for the trees get judged, which one might say, why do the trees have to get judged? So in Halakha, there were all sorts of contradiction in regards to the Maaser. That's why we also chose the topic for later, for the Hartzah, for the lecture, about Parnasah. What does it have to do with it? This contradiction in Chazal, in Halakha, in regards to the Maaser, they weren't 100% sure in regards to the times and how. But the main part of the holiday, I spoke about it the last couple lectures and the last couple days, how every time in the year there are auspicious times that a very special godly light comes to the world, that because that we celebrate the holiday. So on Hanukkah, we think that we celebrate the holiday because of the miracle. Yeah, there was the miracle, there was the Pach Shemen, the oil for 8 days, and they won the war, and okay, so there was a miracle. But more than that, we celebrate it from the same reason, that the special godly light comes to the world. Like a sale, yesterday I told you, it's like in this country, they have sales for every holiday that they have. So we also have sales. Yesterday I mentioned, 4th of July, you get 80% off. Veteran Days, 60% off. Every holiday you get a sale. So we also have sales. We have auspicious times that we can tap into something and get the same thing that what would take me throughout the year a lot of effort and work. On this specific day, it's very easy. So yesterday I mentioned about Pesach, that this is the day that one can tap into this energy, to this light, and easily break out of his slavery. So this specific day, today, is such a special holiday that it's the only holiday that we have on our calendar that we work. We have no problem with working or not working like the rest, most of the holidays. All the holidays that are from the Torah, we're not allowed to work. It's called Mu'adim. It's a festival. You're not allowed to work. It's like a Shabbat. The other holidays like Purim and Hanukkah. So Purim, we have a big feast. Hanukkah, we light candles. Each holiday, we do something. But this holiday didn't get anything. We know Bechlal in the Torah that whatever is the most diminished and the most humble has the biggest and most special meaning. This week we're going to read in the parasha how we got the Torah on Har Sinai. Har is a mountain. Mountain is something big. Sinai is something very small and humble. There's a midrash that says that when they were deciding, there was a debate which mountain we should get the Torah on. So all the mountains were fighting. So one mountain said, you should get it on me because I'm the tallest mountain. The other mountain said, you should give it on me, I'm the widest mountain. And all the mountains were fighting. And the only one who sat quietly was Har Sinai, Mount Sinai. It was small, didn't have any trees on it, didn't have anything, it was like small. And God says, I'm going to give the Torah on this mountain. Because he's humble, he didn't show off, but he's still a mountain. Because there's a question in Chazal, if Hashem wanted humbleness, why did he give it on a mountain? Give it in a valley. Give it on the surface. Why a mountain? Because the Torah teaches us, yeah, you have to be humble. But you still have to be a mountain. You have to rise above. You have to be an example. So we see that we got the Torah on a mountain, but still very humble. So this holiday, there's nothing special to it when you think of it. We don't light candles. We don't get dressed. It's a very humble mountain. humble holiday. Now we see in the Torah, it says in Parashat Shoftim, there's a very interesting pasuk that it says, Ki ha'adam u'etz ha'sadeh. Because the man is the tree of the field. What is it? Doesn't make even sense. A man is the tree of the field. Doesn't make sense. In this pasuk, we have a few very interesting hints why the Torah is calling us a tree. So first thing, if you look at how a tree behaves, that's one way how we can incorporate how we should behave. If you take a tree and you cut it, you'll see rings in the tree, in the wood, which we know how old the tree is, by the rings. This signifies that every year the tree grows a little bit more, and it grows a little bit more, and it grows a little bit more. There's no such a thing that a tree goes smaller. It might stop growing, but there's no such a thing that a tree will grow smaller. Almost anything else in creation has the option of going smaller. But trees will grow, and they grow, and they grow. And if they stop, then they stop. But even if we don't notice that, trees never stop to grow. They always grow. And one sign that signifies it, that it has the rings in the trunk. What we should incorporate and learn from that every year, I have to grow one level higher. And if I'm not as constantly growing, it's like putting the gear in the car in neutral and putting the gas all the way down. It's just noise. We should learn from the tree that every year I have to grow a little bit higher. And I'm not talking about my height. I'm talking about my spiritual level. If I'm not constantly growing in my spiritual level, then I'm not doing the purpose that I was created for. The other thing that you see is, how does the tree start? It starts from nothing. From a little seed that you put in the ground. If you don't put the seed in the ground, it will never grow. So we are this seed. If we don't put ourselves on the ground, we will never grow. And putting yourself on the ground is not to live in all sorts of fantasies. You have to live on the ground. And even if you're very spiritual, you can be the most spiritual person in the world. But the Torah tells you, your feet have to be on the ground. We learn it from so many places. We know that it says in the Gemara about Adam HaRishon, that Hashem put him in this world, and his feet were on the ground. His head was in Shamayim, but his feet were on the ground. Later on, we see with our father, Yaakov, that when he had the dream, of the ladder, Vasulam Mutzav Arza, and the ladder is on the ground. Aval Magia Shamayim, but it's going all the way up. So the Torah constantly tells us, don't fly. Don't pretend you're like some, I don't know what. You're not Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Put your ground, your feet on the ground. If your feet are not on the ground, you'll never ever grow. And how does the tree grow? Besides that it's growing from the power of the ground, this is what's called Koach HaTzomeach, the power that allows the seed to grow. But what really triggers it, what really allows it to grow, is water. Only water. And we know the Torah is compared to water. So in order to grow, you must have the Torah. You cannot grow physically or spiritually without the Torah. The Torah is inseparable with us. And the motion of the tree is to constantly grow. But what's the ultimate part of the tree? Is that it gives fruit. It bears fruit. It doesn't just make shade. It doesn't make a nice green view. It gives fruit. It's productive. This is another thing that Torah is telling us. You have to be productive. You can't just grow and grow and grow. You have to be productive with what you do. Productive means that you have to be productive in your community. You have to be productive in your house. You have to be productive with the education of your kids. You have to be productive in your Avodat Hashem. Now in the olden days, at the time of the Beit HaMikdash, and before and after, they used to bring their maaser, their crops, to the Beit HaMikdash. Now we are eating here this beautiful, tasty dish. I don't know how to say it, but it was very good. Huh?
Just say rice.
Rice. No.
Bilaf.
And we had the fruit and everything. In the olden days, they used to bring only wheat. Only wheat. Why wheat? Wheat in Hebrew is chita. Very good. One of the reasons why they used to bring wheat, because in the pasuk, that it gives us the bracha, the pasuk in the Torah says, "Va'achalta ve'savata ve'verachta," and you should eat, and then you're going to be full, and then you're going to bench, you're going to bless. But the verse continues, "Va'achalta asher la'aretz ha'tova asher Hashem natan lecha." You're going to eat on the land that Hashem gives you. What comes out of the land, what was most important, was the wheat. And a very special hint we see here, that the word wheat in Hebrew is chita. The way we write it is chet tet hey. The numerical value is 22. Corresponding to the 22 letters of Lashon Kodesh of the Aleph Bet. That the same way that the main food is wheat, is bread, that's for the body. But the main food that the neshama needs is the 22 letters of Lashon Kodesh. It's the letters of the Torah. Yes, you need the bread for your body. אבל לא על הלחם לבדו יחיה אדם. Not on the bread. כי המוצא פי השם. Because the words of Hashem, the Torah, that's what a person is living off of. And that's the 22, the hint for the 22 letters of Lashon Kodesh. So they used to bring the wheat. They used to bring the wheat to the Beit HaMikdash. That was part of their maaser. No, no. Chita is with chet. Chet, tet, hey. Not chaf. Some people write it with a yud. But in the Torah, in many places, it says with without a yud. Chita. Chet, tet, hey. So the main part of this holiday, when it comes to teach us what we have to derive, mentioned before, it's an auspicious time, you can tap into it, the sale. This is the day where you can tap into the power of growth, the power that allows you to grow. It once a year, you have a sale that you can tap in, and your growth is spiritual. Almost anyone comes to me after the lecture with all sorts of questions. Everybody's dealing with something. Everybody, even the ones who didn't come to me, they're dealing with something. Everybody's dealing with something. Shem makes sure that everybody has baggage to deal with. And the only way to deal with the baggage that God gives us is only if you grow spiritually. You cannot deal with your problems in this world if you don't grow spiritually. Nothing will solve your problems in this world. Only the Torah. And this is the day you can tap in to the power of growth, like a tree, that you constantly grow, and you grow. And if you're not growing in your spiritual level, like I said before, you're not going to be productive. You're not going to bear fruit. So in this specific time, this auspicious day, this is the day you can tap in. And that's why we don't stop from working. That's why we don't make a special celebration, because the only way to grow in a spiritual level is only if you're humble. If you don't make a whole show out of it. All the rest of the holidays, we make a big feast, and we make holiday, we make all sorts of things. This holiday, no. Because you need to be humble. You want to grow in your spiritual level, you have to be humble. And this is the main part of Tu Bishvat, that it's a time that one can tap in and take off. And the reason why we chose that the continue of this lecture will be about Parnassah, because it's all connected to each other. The Parnassah only comes from the spiritual growth. It doesn't come from anything else. It's coming from your spiritual growth, and Bezrat Hashem, very soon, we're going to bench, we're going to clean up and make the Hatzav of the Parnassah. But take out from this special day that each and every one of us is like a tree. We were planted down in this world for the main reason of to grow and to bear fruit. And my spiritual growth is the base for everything. For my parnasa, for my relationship, for my success in anything. Anything I want to have success in, it's only if I grow spiritually higher. That's what allows me to have the tools to deal with this world. God didn't just choose you to annoy you with something that you have to deal with. Don't look at me like you have nothing to deal with. Everybody's dealing with something. We all have to deal with something. Some things we don't like sharing it, but we all dealing with something. There's a reason for that, because when you deal with something, that's your potential to grow. If everything is good, then you're not going to be in a motion of growing. Especially a Jew. A Jew only grows when he gets quenched. If Hashem doesn't quench you, doesn't press on you, you'll never grow. The Torah says that when they wanted the pure oil, they used to take the olives and they used to quench them, they used to squash them. But they only used the first little drop that came out. Shemen zait zach katit lamaor. When you want to enlight, katit lamaor means that you want to ignite something, you want to light it. They used to light the menorah. They only took the shemen zach, the real purest drop of the oil that comes, the first drop that comes out of the olive. The rest was used for the salad. But the first drop, that's the purest oil. And we are these olives. Hashem needs, He presses us. Because if we don't get pressed, the oil doesn't come out. But the only way to really deal with the problem that we're dealing with and to elevate myself to a high level is only if I incorporate everything that I just told you. I need to have my feet on the ground. I need to water myself, shower myself with Torah. I need to constantly grow with the Torah. With what? With the 22 letters of the Torah. And only when I incorporate all these together, then I can bear fruit. Then I'll be a big and beautiful tree with beautiful fruit, and that's when I can influence my complete surrounding. So Bezrat Hashem, take advantage of this auspicious time that you look into yourself, where you can grow. Every day you can grow. Every day you add one thing into your level. Exactly like the ladder of Yaakov. Every step is one ladder, another step, another step, another step. At the end, comes up to the Shemayim. So Bezrat Hashem, with every little step that you do, we should get a little bit closer to the day of the Geulah. And it should happen very soon. And Bezrat Hashem, the ladder will take us to Eretz Israel, not to the Shemayim. It should happen very fast. In our day, we should marry to see Mashiach right now. Bezrat Hashem, Chag Sameach. And soon we're going to do the next lecture about Parnasa, Nasem Birkat Amazon, and then we'll move on. Chaim l'chaim.